Good day, students. Today we are going to discuss about economies of scale. Very interesting subject. And let's start. Our learning outcomes for today. Number one, at the end of this tutorial video, students will be able to understand what is the concept and principles of the economies of scale. Students will learn how to compute, no? These economies of scale and how to interpret it in the graphical chart. And most importantly, students will appreciate these economies of scale because they will understand that this methodology or concept is very useful, especially if you are in the manufacturing industry or, you know, a service industry. So let's start. Economies of scale. Why is it that price of high-performance laptop is cheaper today than a decade ago? And that is basically true. If you buy this kind of model laptop before or previously, it is quite expensive rather than the laptop today. And why is the average price of smartphones falling even though functions and performance level are always on the rise? And how can IKEA profitably sell flat pack furniture at what seem impossibly low prices? That is true, no? IKEA is very competitive when it comes to knockdown furnitures, no? That is, they have a very good business model, all right? And the answer to these questions is because of the principle of economies of scale. Scale economies have brought down the unit cost of production and have fed through lower prices for consumers. So the unit cost we are referring here is the price per unit. Okay. Alright. So to proceed, we have some scope and delimitation. One is, I will highly suggest to my subscribers and viewers to try to go back and watch the tutorial video about cost volume profit analysis, because that is very important so that you can add more additional inputs for this topic, economies of scale. One of the delimitation is we will only discuss the concept and application of economy of scale. We will not discuss about the different economy of scales or type of economy of scales, which is the internal economy and the external economy. And we will not discuss in this tutorial video about this economy of scale. We will have a separate future tutorial videos for our delimitations, all right? I promise you that. All right. So, let's look at this. Economies of scale occur when unit costs fall as output rises. So, meaning to say, if this is your volume of production, right, or quantity of production, once it increases, your unit cost goes down. That is the principle of economies of scale. Now, okay, let us remove this one. Economies of scale are the cost advantages that a business can exploit by expanding their scale of production. Meaning to say, these economies of scale can be very useful for manufacturing industries or corporations if they will study how their resources can be transformed so that they can increase their production quantity. So, if they can do that, the effect of economies of scale is to reduce the unit cost of production. Right? And here, you can see that this one is the average cost per unit. You can see here in the y-axis, this is the average cost per unit. Right? And you can see here in the x-axis is the quantity of output. However, in this particular graphical representation, it is the quantity of output is represented by the quarter frame of an annual year. All right. So, if you can see here, this is the cost curve line, okay, and it's like a letter U or letter V, no? So if you are going to project your average cost per unit, okay, at this price and try to intersect that to that cost curve line, on the Q1 item, Q1 quantity is this much only, and the average cost needed to produce that product is ranging from this amount. Now, if they are going to produce more in the second quarter, so the average cost becomes lower. And if they will continue to increase their volume in Q3, it will have a significant reduction if that is AC3. And that is the principle of economies of scale. Now, there is a point here that the graph will go up because that is already the bottom level, so the graph will tend to go up. And if you tend to go up, your average unit cost will now increase, and that is called this economy of scale. And we will not deal on that. We will just deal on the economies of scale. Okay? Now, economies of scale work best when your fixed costs are high. Remember, guys, total expenses consist of variable expenses and fixed costs. When we say variable expenses, we mean to say that your variable cost is going to increase, okay, if the volume production increases. If volume production decreases, your variable cost decreases. Regardless of output in the fixed cost, whether it goes, production volume goes up or it goes down, vice versa, it's still a fixed cost. Let's try to learn more. Okay. So let's have a graph, tabulated data, so that we can try to get the richness and learning of this. So we say that economies of scale, as you increase your volume, your unit cost decreases. Alright. So this is the output on this column. You have 50, 100, 150, 200, and 250. And regardless of the quantity or the production volume, your fixed cost is constant. We know that. Okay. And we know for a fact, okay, that the variable cost, okay, if volume increases, your variable cost also increases. So at 50, it's 5,100. So if it increases, this one increases also. Okay? You can see here, no? This one. 200 becomes 20, 150 becomes 15K, 100 it becomes 10K. Right? So you can see the principle of this variable cost. Alright. So, we are going to compute the total cost. The total cost is equivalent to fixed cost plus variable cost. So, the total cost is this one. 10K plus 5 gives you 15. 10 plus 10 gives you 20K. 10K plus 15 gives you 25K. And 10 plus 20 gives you 30K. And 10 plus 25 gives you 35K. So, this total cost is the total cost of the expenses because it combines your fixed expense and variable expense. Alright. Okay. So, we will now compute the cost per unit. Right? So, we simply divide, okay, we simply divide the total cost from the quantity, okay? So, 300 divide 50 gives you, 15,000 divide 50 gives you 300. So, this 300 can be taken, your cost per unit, the formula will be your total cost divided by the quantity for that particular period. So, it gives you now 300. So, we go to the next, okay? At 100 production volume and the total cost of expenses to produce that 100 units is 20K. So, 20,000 divided by 100 gives you a unit cost of 200. So, you can see the application of the theory of economies of scale. We said that economy of scale, once you increase the volume, your unit cost tends to go down. That is the principle of economy of scale. So you produce 150, okay, let us erase this. On that particular third period, okay, you tend to increase your production by 50 units. Okay, that 150, okay, so the total cost is 25 divided by 150 gives you 166 cost per unit. So it really is going down. And this 150 can be computed, 30,000 divided by 200, okay, it gives you a unit cost of 150. So, the principle and concept of economies of scale is very alive. And you can see here through our computation that once you increase your volume, the unit price tends to go down. Okay? And finally, at 250, it gives you 35,000 divided by 250, your unit cost becomes 140. Okay? So, that is a very good example and appreciation of the beauty and application of the economies of scale, how you are going to compute your total expenses or total cost by adding fixed cost plus variable cost. And we know for a fact that the variable cost is directly proportional to production, while fixed cost, it is constant, no, regardless of the quantity of production. Let us proceed. So now, here, we compare the operational efficiency on the unit cost of these particular businesses, no? So, as the table is shown, which of the five businesses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, is more efficient over that period? Okay, so again, how to compute the unit cost? It is 50,000 divided by 50,000 divided by 10,000 gives you 5. Okay, now unit cost again for business B, total expenses is 80 divided by 20 gives you 4. Okay, now here the output for business C is 5,000, the total cost is 30,000 divided by 5,000 gives you 6. Right now, business D, 75,000 is the variable total cost divided by 25 gives you 3. And this one divided by 15,000 gives you 5. So you can see here inside the rectangle that really, okay, business D is very efficient and has the competitive advantage over the other businesses. So meaning to say, in this presentation, business D has the highest output, that's why, though the total expense is 75K, same is true with business E, and business C is greater than, but the production volume is very small. Okay, so business D is the most efficient and has more competitive advantage over those businesses. Okay, so that is another example of operational efficiency using the economies of scale. All right, so our reference is Jim Reilly, copyright 2018, Economies of Scale, Tutor 2U Business, downloaded from this URL address, dated November 2, 2020. So thank you very much for joining me in this my tutorial video. And next time, we are going to discuss those tutorial videos about those limitations about, you know, the types of economies of scale, this economy of scale. We will discuss that later on. So thank you very much for joining me. Please continue to subscribe, like, and share my tutorial video. Keep safe, everyone. Thank you.